Welcome back to another video. So in today's video, I'm going to show you how to do polygel extensions using forms. So as you know, I normally do acrylic extension, and this is my first ever try with the polygel, and that's the reason I decided to go with forms. So before we start, please don't forget to hit that subscribe button and the bell icon to get notified about all my new videos. Model One's team sent me these polygel extension kits as part of their PR program, and as you can see on the screen, this kit has everything that you needed for the polygel extension. So in this particular one, we have 6 different types of polygels, and then we have a filer, and we have a brush, and a base coat, top coat, and the tips, and also they have included a couple of nail decoration items. So today I'm going to use this particular shade 005 nude for our extension. So I'm just quickly going to show you all the items that we need to do the extension. So here is the brush that comes with the kit, and as you can see, one side we have the brush and the other side is the spatula. So you can use the spatula to pick up the product from the tube, and then you can apply the product using the brush. And then we have the slip solution, and then we have the base coat, and we also have the top coat. And since I'm going to use nail forms, I have these nail forms that I got from one of the Insta sellers, retailers. So I'm going to use these forms. And apart from all of these, we also need dehydrator and the primer to prep our natural nails. So my natural nail, I have already removed my previous extension and it's almost ready to go with the new extension. So I filed, I removed my cuticle and everything, and now I'm going to start with a dehydrator. In case if you're not familiar with the natural nail preparation, then please visit my first acrylic extension video. I have explained it in detail there. I'll put the link somewhere on the screen here as well. So what I'm doing right now is I'm applying the dehydrator. So the dehydrator helps to remove any excess oil that remains on the nail surface. So that's what I'm doing. As you can see on the screen, the moment you apply it, it evaporates. So that's how the dehydrator works. Once you're done with the dehydrator, you can start applying the primer. So you only need a little thin layer of primer that you need to apply onto your natural nails. So for today's extension, I'll be using this 005 nude color polygel. And when you open a brand new polygel tube, you should see this seal, and then you have to remove the seal, and then you push out the product and then you use it. So you can either use your spatula or you can directly apply the product from the tube also. However it is convenient for you, you can do it in your way. So I am going to push out the product and I'm going to start building my nails. In order to sculpt the nails, we need a foundation or a base. So for that, as I mentioned in the beginning of the video, I'm using nail forms. So if you don't have nail forms, no problem. The kit has those nail tips. You can use those tips to build the extension. I wanted to do the form, so that's why I am using form. So what you're seeing on the screen is I'm prepping the form and I'm fitting the form onto my nails. And once this is done, I'll be starting with my base coat application. Once the form fitting is done, then I'm applying a very thin layer of base coat, and then I'm going to cure it under the UV lamp. Actually, this step I was supposed to do it before applying the form, but anyways, I forgot, so I did it later and then I cured it under the UV lamp for like 30 seconds. Next, pour some slip solution onto the dappin dish, and then you can dip your brush like that to prep it, and then you can start with the extension. Next, I have picked up some product from the tube onto my spatula, and then I'm transferring that product onto the free edge of my nails. Once you place the bead, you can use your brush. First you dip your brush into the slip solution and then remove all the excess liquid from the brush, and then you come back here and you are going to press it on sidewise, and then you are going to build the length and shape of your extension. So if you have like too much liquid on your brush, then that is also not good. You should only have like a little, just to manipulate the gel to build the structure of your nails. So that's what I'm doing. So if you see, the bead that I placed, the starting place, I'm ensuring that it's very thin, and then I'm dragging the product out and I'm simultaneously building the length and shape of the nail. So keep on watching this. Once you're happy with the free edge and the length and shape of the extension, then you can quickly cure it under the UV lamp for 30 seconds. After that, we will start with the second bead, or rather we will do the rest of the nails. So after curing it, I placed the second bead near my cuticle area. So if you notice, I accidentally placed it too close to my cuticle area. So you should be putting or placing the second bead a little far from the cuticle area, and then you work towards the cuticle area. So I'm going to fix that, but just remember that you will not keep the second bead too close to your cuticle area. So now I have almost completed the extension. Unfortunately, I forgot to hit the record button while I was managing this part of the nails. So I don't have that clip, but I successfully managed the apex and the application of the product. So now I will cure it under the UV lamp for 60 seconds and then I'll remove the foams. At this stage, in case if you see any error or imperfections, you can still go ahead and fix it, and then we will start with filing and shaping. So for the filing and shaping, I'll be using Model 1's 100-180 grit nail filer. This filer is also included in that polygel kit I was referring to. And when I do the filing, I start from the sidewalls and I make sure the shape is intact, and then I start with the nail surface area. So in this video, I did not use the e-file. So for polygel, actually it's very easy to file and shape compared to acrylic. It was so easy, so I didn't have to use my e-file. So just file, shape, and then you can apply the top coat. I'm almost done with the filing and shaping of my nails. After this filing and shaping, I'll be using a buffer block to buff off all the imperfections, scratch marks, etc. And then you can apply your top coat or the gel color, whatever you wanted to, and you will be done. While cleaning up my nails, I noticed another thing. So if you see, you can see some small marks here, right? So these are the bubble marks. So I am not sure how this happened, whether it's from the brush or it's from the poly gel. I'm not sure, but I'm assuming it's from the brush, because in the initial time I was using extras slip solution to, you know, move around the gel. So I think that's what caused it, but just be careful. Anyways, I have to figure it out. This is just my first attempt. So with that dusting, our nail extensions are ready. I had so much fun sculpting nails using poly gel. As I mentioned, this was my first ever trial and I'm so happy with the results. I know I can improve it a lot. In case if you are an expert in poly gel extension, or you have so much information or knowledge about this extension, please feel free to share your thoughts, feedbacks, etc. in the comment section. And in case if you have any question, please don't hesitate to leave your comments. I'll try to answer all your questions. So what I'm doing right now is I'm just directly applying a top coat and I'm going to cure it, and my extensions will be complete. Now I think that's it for today's video. In case if you like this video, please don't forget to like, share, comment, all those good things, and also don't forget to subscribe. And in case if you wanted to buy the polygel extension kit by Model 1's, you can check it out in their website. I'll put all the links in the description box. You can also use my code AMMU10 to get a 10% off across their site. So that's it for today. I'll see you soon. Stay safe, stay happy. Thank you guys.